We are here at the 19th International Ayurveda Symposium in Bierstein, and with me is Dr. Vijay Murthy from the UK. Dr. Murthy, you are an experienced Ayurveda doctor. What motivates you to come here to this event?
For me, coming to Bierstein Symposium is like being on a pilgrimage. Because, you know, in my everyday environment, in my practice, in my research, I don't get to meet so many highly intellectually engaged and scholarly and passionate Ayurvedic experts and Ayurvedic learners coming together. So for me, this is a very special time of the year where I charge myself with all the motivation and inspiration I need to be doing the best for my patients and in my practice.
Is there any special topic you're particularly interested in?
You know, over the years, coming to Bierstein Symposium, every year there's a specific theme. And I must say, the theme this year particularly interested me. Because to talk about ojas, prana, and tejas, these are words that are commonly used, but seldom very clearly explored and explained. So I was really very engaged in listening to Dr. Ram Manohar's talk on ojas, tejas, and prana, and Dr. Antonio Morandi's microcirculation in Ayurveda, because I think, you know, what happens at this conference particularly is, as individual Ayurvedic or healthcare experts, we try to kind of navigate through this field on our own to a certain extent. But here you come where it's the melting pot of all different brains and hearts that in a very engaged, purposeful way start to talk about these topics. And what this does is something that you cannot get anywhere else or through any other experience.
Why is the topic of ojas so important for Ayurveda and the patients?
Yes, the topic of ojas particularly is important for Ayurveda at this point in time because now we have started to look at diseases and health in a completely different way than what we would have done 10 years ago or 20 years ago. For instance, you know, let me give the example of cancer. So we are starting to question whether cancer is entirely related to genetics, or is there something to do with immune system? Is there something to do with the metabolic system? And where do we get the answers? We would need to go back to Ayurveda. And when you go back to Ayurveda, Ayurveda looks at the development or contribution to a disease process based on very subtle concepts like understanding ojas or understanding prana or understanding tejas. So these concepts are very complex and they're very timely because through these models we now can understand the current solutions possibly for chronic illnesses we are facing. I mean, that's how I see why it's useful in practice. For instance, you know, if I'm seeing a patient who is diagnosed with cancer, who has just undergone conventional treatment of cancer and is looking for prevention, you know, tertiary prevention, secondary prevention, where do I go? What do I need to actually impart in this patient? Is to increase that person's ojas. And how do I do that? I would have to go back to understanding ojas and how to do that from an Ayurvedic perspective.
What's your experience in cooperating with conventional doctors who are practicing conventional medicine?
Yeah, I feel that it is very important that conventional medical doctors and experts in other paradigms of healthcare must meet together because we are in an era where it is not about the system, it is about the patient. And what is true patient-centered care needs a collaboration between conventional medical doctors and Ayurveda physicians much more than ever. And I'm a great advocate for integrative medicine.
What could conventional doctors motivate to come here? What would you recommend?
I certainly would recommend, particularly this symposium, if conventional medical doctors would want to gain an understanding of Ayurveda. I say this because although there are lots of information out there on the internet and elsewhere on Ayurveda, they're so simplistic that it may sometimes actually discourage conventional medical doctors to even believe that Ayurveda is a systematic body of thinking. But whereas you come here to Beer Stein, that every single lecture kind of takes you back to the scientific, systematic approach that Ayurveda is based on, which exactly is what conventional medical doctors would be yearning to understand. What's the theory behind these practices? Or how does the practice of Ayurveda relate to the theory or the theoretical model of healthcare? And therefore, I would say this, I would recommend, is one of the best places for conventional medical doctors to get initiated into understanding Ayurveda.
It's a good vision for this conference. Well, thank you very much, Dr. Murthy.
Thank you.